بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قال تبارك وتعالى كما ورد في سورة المائدة وتعاونوا على البر والتقوى ولا تعاونوا على الإثم والعدوان رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي واجعل لي وزيرا من أهلي آمين يا رب العالمين. So my topic for today is etiquettes of working together and why we should work together and how to synergize Muslim community. And the shallow translation of this phrase from Surah Al-Ma'idah, ayat number 2, where Allah says, ta'awun ulal birri wa taqwa, cooperate with each other in all the good projects. If one organization in Muslim community is doing something and the other organization in Muslim community is doing some other thing, they both should cooperate in good projects. وَلَا تَعَوَنُوا وَلَا الْإِثْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ, and do not help, do not cooperate with each other in bad projects. The ayah is very simple. But before I can actually share with you my own reflections and from the few tafaseer, I got few gems from few tafaseer. Before I can share that, let me just start this with the dua that may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all from COVID. Ameen ya Rab. I just came back from Pakistan, and some of you are already aware that Alhamdulillah, I had a great trip. But in the beginning, it was a roller coaster of a trip because I got COVID second or third day I landed. But Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was very kind with me and my wife that we got cured in Alhamdulillah after 2 weeks. And then even our kids had mild symptoms. But may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give shifa kamila to all the brothers and sisters who are still struggling with COVID. Ameen ya Rab. There are a few brothers in our community who have requested for the dua. Brother Mongi, Brother Abu Muhammad, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows them best. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them complete shifa kamila. Ameen ya Rab. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant all the brothers and sisters Jannatul Firdaus and the status of Shaheed who passed away, rahimahullah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all from all the spiritual and physical diseases. Ameen ya Rab. My humble request to all of you before I can start is actually to keep smiling because it's a sunnah, and also abide by social distancing protocols. So alhamdulillah, I can see all of you are wearing mask, but obviously we have to wear mask properly. Mask is useless if your nose and mouth is not covered. Secondly, no handshakes, no hugging. I know I came back from Pakistan. I'm anxious to meet some of you and vice versa. But again, we don't want an outbreak of COVID here. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect all of us. And so please abide social distancing protocols, inshallah. So working together, or etiquettes of working together, or synergizing Muslim community. First of all, if you think about Islamic work or community work or giving back to the community, what we can do as an American Muslim here, let's talk about Massachusetts, or let's talk about New England. Some of you are part of well-functional, good-functional masjid, mashallah. Masjid is the heart of the community. And ask those brothers and sisters who are living in US for decades and they don't have good, well-functional masjid right next to their neighborhood, ask them the value of good masjid. And they will tell you that you are very lucky that you have a well-functional Islamic center. So this is one Islamic work where we can volunteer. Other is Islamic school. A good functional Islamic school, that's a backbone of any community. Then you move on to the relief work, international and local both. There are brothers and sisters in Syria, in Palestine, in Uyghur, in Rohingya. There's so many, the entire Ummah is struggling right now. So to give them some kind of relief, that's what community work is. And then local relief work. There are Muslims in the community who are having hard time to pay the rent. Maybe they have lost the job because of COVID and now they're struggling. So to help them, there are so many things we can do in terms of giving back to the community and doing things together. Then combating Islamophobia. We need to have an organization, and alhamdulillah, we have organizations like CARE and so on and so forth, which are taking care of the Muslim community. And then we need academic institute, Hifz Madrasas, the seminaries which teach our kids, our boys and our girls, how to be Islamic leader and teach them advanced Islamic studies. So there are so many areas of working together. But how to work together? when we have different labels and organization, and obviously we want to focus on different things. This is telling us 4 or 5 things, and I just want to say it briefly because this khutbah is very short. First, what are we learning from this? تَعَوَنُوا عَلَى الْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى وَلَا تَعَوَنُوا عَلَى الْإِثْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ. The shallow translation, as I said, help each other, cooperate each other in good projects, and do not help each other, do not cooperate with each other in bad projects. What does this mean? First thing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that we as an individual or we as an organization cannot do everything. So we need to help others in their good project, and others will help in our good projects. If you will expect from any individual or from any organization that they can do everything, that's a false expectation. That's a zulm on that person or that organization, and that's a zulm on the entire Muslim community. Because we cannot focus on everything. We do not have capacity and resources for everything. So we have to help others in their good project, and we can continue our good projects, and that's how we can serve the Ummah. Because at the end of the day, it's not my name and your name, it's the name of the Ummah. That should be our goal, that should be our mindset. And I'll give you this example without going into too much detail, like Imam Umar Suleiman. Now, I'm just using his name as an example. He's running an institute, Yaqeen Research Institute. If you are obsessed with the personality of Imam Umar Suleiman, and you will say, actually, he is so good, he should run a masjid also, and he should run Islamic school also, and he should do this also, and he should have a relief organization also. No, that's a zulm on Imam Umar Suleiman. If he's doing one thing good, let him do that. So we can focus on other things and he can support us, and vice versa. That's what we are learning from this ayah, ta'awanu ala al-birri wa taqwa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not saying here, do all the good things by yourself. Allah says ta'awun, help each other, cooperate each other in all the good projects. Tell me who is more or who is best of the companions, Abu Bakr, Umar, or Abu Huraira? All the companions were great, but we all know who was more knowledgeable, Abu Bakr and Umar. Who was best of them, Abu Bakr and Umar? There is no, it's an undeniable fact. But who narrated more hadith? Abu Huraira. Rarely you will find hadith narrated by Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu. Although he was the most knowledgeable among the companions. Why? Abu Huraira knew his role radiallahu anhu. Abu Bakr and Umar knew his role. They didn't say, no, actually let us go back to teaching instead of administrative issues of the Khilafah, because that's how we're going to get our name in the hadith books. No. Everyone played their part, and eventually they served the Ummah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's what we need to do if we understand our role here, subhanAllah. The only person who did this, all the things together, was Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But he was Prophet, he have to do this all by himself. But we as a human being, we cannot. So we have to help others, and we have to know our limitations. Second thing we are learning from this ayah, ta'awanu alal birri wa taqwa wa la ta'awanu alal ismi wal udwan. Again, what this ayah means, help each other in good projects and do not cooperate with each other in bad projects, in sin and animosity. What does this ayah mean? Second lesson, we have to complement each other, but we do not have to compete with each other. This is extremely important lesson for all of us. See, we are living in a consumerism, or we are living in a capitalist society. And as a capitalist society, its materialistic thinking affect the decisions we make in our daily life. And it even impact Muslim community in our microscopic aspects of our decision making. So instead of competing with each other, what we should do at an organizational level, we don't have to reinvent the wheel. We don't simply have to waste our resources and duplicate the same process. We can complement each other. Like if we are running a good successful masjid or successful relief organization, then we don't need to have a separate activity within our organization to combat Islamophobia. We need a national project for that. So you don't waste your resources when things are being done nationally for the same reason. Similarly, if you are a relief organization, you know you are not community. Community is your local masjid. Don't just waste your resources in the domain which is not your expertise. We need to work together to achieve a higher goal. But only if we understand this point, we have to complement and not compete with each other. Third, third thing from we are learning from ta'awun ulal birri wa taqwa. Help each other in good projects. Do not help each other in bad projects. What we are learning. Third thing, you don't have to. And this is, by the way, very important. You don't have to completely agree with someone before helping him. That's one of the problems we have in our mindset. That this person doesn't agree with the bylaws of my organization, I won't help him in his project. No. Allah is clearly giving us guideline. تَعَوَنُوا لَلْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى وَلَا تَعَوَنُوا لِلْإِسْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ. Help them in good projects and do not help them in bad projects. خلاص. If you find compatibility with your values, help them. If you find a conflict, don't help them. Simple formula which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us. Unfortunately, we Muslims, like other religions, have divided ourselves in so many things. Like from religious label standpoint, from ideological standpoint, from even political ideological standpoint. Are you a conservative or liberal in terms of American politics as a Muslim? So on, so forth. And because of that, we are not synergizing our effort. We are duplicating our efforts and wasting the resources of community, subhanAllah. The ayah is telling us that you don't have to do this, subhanAllah. Like, for example, Muslims working with Christians. In terms of racial injustice, we should be the first one to do this. And if Christians are doing, we should do it together. Social injustice, we'll do it together. Whether it's Christians, Jews, so on and so forth. But when it comes to Christmas is coming, let's worship Jesus. No. That's our clear principle that we cannot worship. We respect Jesus as a prophet, but he's not God. So there should be a fine line. تَعَوَنُوا لِلْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى وَلَا تَعَوَنُوا لِلْإِسْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ. And the last thing we are learning from this ayah. If we want to do something big in our life, if we want to benefit the masses, we cannot do things alone. We need to do things together. Can you move simple furniture of your house by yourself? Can you move this podium here by yourself? No. You will need the help of someone. How can you move the state of the Muslim community from darkness to light by yourself? You need help. You need help. So if you are thinking, no, I will do everything, come out of that foolishness. You cannot do. Please forgive me for being so blunt. If you will ask me in a simple language, without giving all these points, that Imam said, what does it mean in a simple language? تَعَوَنُوا لَلْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى وَلَا تَعَوَنُوا لَلْإِسْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ. That help each other in good projects, do not help each other in bad projects. What does this mean in simple language? In simple language, basically it means that don't open another masjid, another Islamic school, another relief organization just because you didn't get the leadership position in the first one. If there is no need, don't open it. Unless there is a genuine need. If it's space issue, capacity issue, that makes sense. Because all of these are charitable projects. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us wisdom. Ameen ya Rab. Sometimes crushing your ego is better than crushing the entire Muslim community. Remember this. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the ability to internalize this. Ameen ya Rab. Also work always for the sake of Allah. Because if I am working for my name and my fame, then I would never like to help other projects. Because I'm not getting credit if your organization will do well. So if you're working for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and considering ummah goal, then these things won't matter. Subhanallah. And the last thing before we can inshallah end with few announcement, conclude with few announcement. When Allah says ta'awanu lal birri wa taqwa, I told you. But Allah also says wala ta'awanu lal ismi wal udwan. Help each other in good things, in righteous things. But do not help each other in sin and in animosity. Udwan is animosity, aggression. Many a times we are doing community work. Many a times we are doing Islamic work. We are activists in our community because we are negatively charged because of this animosity. I want to show him I'm doing this, right? I'm good. I'm better than what you think. Allah saying, don't do that. Two organizations fighting with third organization and they are actually teaming up. وَلَا تَعْوَنْ وَلَا الْإِسْمِ وَالْعُضْوَانِ. Don't have this negative energy. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all the ability to understand this. Ameen ya Rab. If you are thinking right now, I have a few minutes inshallah. If you are thinking right now, Imam Asif, Jazakallahu Khairan for your khutbah, but this khutbah is not relevant for us. This khutbah is only relevant for the people who are working in community. Volunteers in masjid, volunteers in Islamic school, maybe relief organization, helping widows, helping orphans. But this is not relevant for everyone. And I agree with you that this khutbah is meant for that audience. But then my question to you is, what is the purpose of your life? And I'm sorry for being so blunt, but what is the purpose of your life? Is the purpose of your life is just to work, earn money, have a family, watch Netflix, post unnecessary stuff on Facebook, and waste time? Is that the purpose of your life? Ask yourself. Even animals have living. Even animals have a family. They might not have Netflix for entertainment, but they have their own forms of entertainment. Why Allah created me and you? أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ. So we can benefit the community. Not for ourselves, for the people. Are we giving it back to community? Ask yourself. If this khutbah is not relevant for you, ask yourself, where I wasted my entire life? What is your legacy? Ask yourself. Once you will die, let's say tonight, if angel of death will come to me, Asif Irani, and to you, what face we will show to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Will we say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah, I actually watch 10 hours of Netflix every single week? You know the answer how you are feeling right now. If this khutbah is not relevant for you, then seriously ask yourself. Maybe next time I hear something like this, inshallah I will do something that it will become more relevant. So I will become active volunteers in Islamic organizations. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the wisdom. It's easy to criticize. Oh, this masjid have politics, this Islamic school have politics, this have this issue, and drink chai and sleep. You don't have right to say anything until you come and you give your time and you give your energy. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us wisdom. Ameen ya Rabb. Please make dua for the entire ummah. Allahumma ansuril Islam wal muslimin. Allahumma akzul man khazal ad-deen Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa la taj'alna ma'hum. Allahumma la tada' lana dhanban illa ghafarta wa la hamman illa farajta wa la daynan illa qadayta. والحاجة من حوائج الدنيا والآخرة إلا قضيتها يا أرحم الراحمين ولا مريضا إلا شفيت ولا ميتا إلا رحمت ولا ضالا إلا هديت يا أرحم الراحمين
الله أكبر